Hi guys, and welcome to part 29 of D-Point V's Fire Red Adventure for GBA. Continuing where we left off last time, we're just going to battle this trainer, and she's like, you shall join us. So Channeler Roof would like to battle, and she sends out a level 22 Ghastly. So I'm going to send out my Kaplunk, which is a Jolteon, and is at level 32, so 10 levels clear of it, and I'm just going to give it a Shockwave. So, we gain 447 experience from that battle, and 704 Pokédollars for winning. Now, if you come down here, apart from a wild battle, anyway, there's, as I said in the last video, you can catch Ghastlies and you can catch the occasional Haunter in here. I'm just going to battle this one first. Give me your all. Yeah, I will. But anyway, she has a Haunter, so at level 23, so it's not too difficult, you should be able to take it down. So we knocked out on a one hit KO, so we gained 621 experience, and we defeated Channeler Tammy. Gasp. Oh well. So anyway, if you come down here, Cumchard, I've purified this space, you can rest here. If you step in here, you enter part the purified and projecting zone, your Pokemon are fully healed. That item's a cleanse tag. And cleanse tags held by Pokemon, it repels wild Pokemon if the party is first in the party. So I'm gonna give it to Kaplunk, as it's first in the party. Now zombies. No. But anyway, let's battle this Channeler Roof. No, not Channeler Roof. Channeler Karina. So, level 24 Ghastly. Just give it a Shockwave. And it's a one-hit KO, as per usual in this tower. This is just because you could go up this far earlier, but you couldn't go right the way to the top. So, the people at the top will be a lot tougher. So we're going to switch Kaplunk for Wildfire. Not bag. We're just going to give Wildfire the cleanse tag to hold, because I'm getting annoyed with Ghastlies. Because you've seen them, you don't need to see any more of them particularly. So anyway. Found one nugget, which you can sell at Pokemarts. So she's sniffing this trainer. So we're going to battle Channeler Janine. Or Janie. Whatever, I can't be bothered. Doesn't matter. So we're just going to battle the Channeler. So anyway. Ghastly fainted just with a... just an Ember attack. So we defeated the Channeler. Don't make these names hard to... make these names hard to pronounce, do they? Oh. Flipping out, this cleanse tag doesn't work. Level 13 Ghastly can break through it when its Wildfire's holding it. This is ridiculous. If you're gonna make an item, at least make it well. So if you take a step forward, or actually, go down here, and you can find an X accuracy. So we're gonna battle this Channeler. Give me blood. Right, so Channeler Angelina, or Angelica, yeah, Angelica, it's an out of level 22 Ghastly, so we're going to use Ember on it. So 447 experience, so another Ghastly is up next, so we're going to use Ember on it. So that's Ghastly gone at level 22. So 447 experience, and she's going to use another Ghastly. Great. Level 22. Let's use Ember. So critical hit. It always comes down to critical hits. So anyway, 447 experience, and we defeated the Channeler. So she's groaning. So anyway, the head up here, we come face to face with another one who just goes key 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 key, like she's laughing to herself. So this is Channeler Jennifer, would like to battle, and she sent out a Ghastly. Level 24 though, well that makes her any better, so we're gonna use Ember on it. So Ghastly fainted, and we get 487 experience, and we defeated Channeler Jennifer. You're gonna have to battle this one, and she's Qua. She's just shouting random stuff. So Channeler Amelia, that's it, Amelia. So Ember. I couldn't really read the name there on my screen because I'm narrating this. I'm narrating this after I've recorded the footage. I recorded this footage a few days ago, and I'm recording it and I'm narrating it about 2 days after. So we're gonna learn Flamethrower now. So that's pretty awesome at level 34. So we forgot Growl and we learned Flamethrower, which is a pretty good fire type attack behind Flare Blitz and some of the later type attacks, but I like Flamethrower. So we're going to just switch it over to Mentalist now. Down here you can find yourself a rare candy, so it's worth just coming up and picking that up. Rare candies raise your... so be gone, intruders. So there's a ghost, is it level 30? The Sylph Scope unveiled the ghost identity. It's that Marowak that everyone was talking about that was killed. If you came up here earlier before going through the rocket hideout and taking on the boss, you'd just come to the ghost and your Pokemon would be too scared to move. So it's not really advisable. So a headbutt, it's used on me, so I'm going to just use Recover just to gain that extra bit of just restore my health. So it's using Leer. I'm going to use Psybeam on it once again. Oh, like one hit point. So it's using Focus Energy now. So I'm not sure. Shall I use Psybeam? Yeah, I'll use Psybeam. I'm not going to risk it, even though it's got one hit point left. So we defeated Wild Marowak. 531 experience. And the ghost was Restless Spirits of Kubo Mother. The Mother Spirit was calmed. It departed to the afterlife. Anyway, join us next time as we take on the top